that.
Okay, now California, I have a call before you. It's Ski Carrier, so I'm going to have to take that person call first, and then I will take your call if you're still on the line. So if you want to be patient, you can continue, and I'll get to you after Ski Carrier. If not, then be sure you call in next week on Wednesday or Thursday, but I pray and hope that you will stay online so that you can get your deliverance. Okay. Okay, Ski Carrier, that's your sign-in name. So you do want a session, is that correct?
Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
You do want, can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Okay, you do want a session, is that correct?
Yes, my friend wants a session.
You said your friend?
Yes. By the way, this is Anita over in Tampa, Florida, Evangelist King. It's nice to talk to you again.
You're your friend.
I got one of my sisters here. This was that you missed earlier.
All right. You can put her on, Anita.
I'm going to put Renee on with you.
Okay.
Hello?
Yeah, how you doing, Renee?
All right, how are you?
All right, that's great. Well, praise God for such great friends. You know, they're interested in you getting totally delivered. Now, that's a friend that we really need. That truly is a friend.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what are you expecting of the Lord out of this conversation?
Ma'am?
Can you hear me?
I can hear you, but it's like...
What's that? Let me see if I can get it.
Hold on. She's from the...
Okay.
I also have one live to the Evangelist King.
Yeah.
You know me. I told you I'm determined to get you. Determined to contact you.
Okay.
It's online?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm so serious.
Can
you hear me now, Renee?
Right down there.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, just put it right down.
Okay. Yes, ma'am?
Hello?
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me?
Oh, yes, she can hear you.
Okay. Now, I'm not on speaker, am I?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I don't want it on speaker because this is just me and Renee.
Okay. Let me just take my hips on in my room.
Okay.
You on the phone?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay.
All right. Okay, Renee, let me ask you now. When did you give your life to Jesus?
Oh, it's a long time ago, but I have been doing a lot of backsliding.
You done a lot. Well,
you ain't got no. Hold on just a minute. You ain't got no phone. I can't hardly hear. Okay, put it on speaker. Hello.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Okay. I can hear you a little bit. Hello?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Okay, I got you. No, I can hear you.
Okay. All right. Well, let me ask you, Renee, now, when you first came to Jesus Christ, did you ever go through a true deliverance?
No, ma'am. I don't think so.
Well, that's why you kept backsliding. That's the reason why you kept backsliding, Renee. It's because when you first come to Jesus Christ, it's your spirit. You were birthed into the family of God, born into the family of God. That is your spirit. You know, we are actually a spirit. We have a soul, which is a mind, will, emotion, and we live in this body for this earth.
Mm-hmm.
So actually, when you first came to Jesus, it was your spirit was born again, birthed into God's family. But your soul, those devils, demons were still living or residing in your soul and in your body, your mind, your will, emotion. So therefore, when you left that service or wherever you was at, when you gave your life to Jesus, But there was never a non-appointed servant of God in confronting those devils to come out. You left that place with devils. And so devils' aim is to kill, steal, and destroy. They always lead you right back into darkness. So that's the reason why you backslid. That's the reason why it's been hard for you to serve the Lord, because those devils were still in your soul realm and still in your body. Understand?
Uh-huh.
That's why you backslid.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why you've been having problems backsliding. So that was in time past. So, but what about now? Now, Renee.
Ma'am.
What are you doing now? Are you at least trying to serve the Lord with all your heart?
Yes, ma'am.
You're not in any type of sexual relationship.
No, ma'am. I don't. I got this person. I've been trying to ignore this person, but it keeps coming back at me. So
my question is: you're not in no type of sexual relationship.
I don't have a relationship, but I am having like sex though, but not no relationship.
But that is a relationship. And that is a relationship, Renee. So you are having a sexual relationship
with
a young man now. Now, what have the Father been telling you about this relationship? Because I know the Holy Spirit been convicting you about this relationship.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It has.
I know he has. Now, you two are not living together. Is that correct?
No, ma'am. He's gone.
He's gone now, but when he gets ready, then he'll probably come back, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So now you do know that you have to give up that sexual relationship.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you willing to give it up? Have you repented?
Yes, ma'am.
Ask God to forgive you for that sexual relationship.
Yes, ma'am.
You have asked the Lord to forgive you?
Yes, ma'am. I have.
Okay. Great. Now, are you attending in the church?
I'm not a member, but I do go to certain churches and I do walk.
You don't have to be a member, but are you still at least trying to find a church? You have not given up on assembling yourself with the saints.
No, I haven't given up. I just don't go as regular as you should.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So also now, are you watching the type of people that you befriend or that you hang around with? Are you careful about that developing?
Yes, ma'am. I had got myself, well, not involved with it, but they keep. Like you speak and you sit and you talk and you. This is what I do. I sit, I speak, I talk, and I get up and go. I don't have no friends. I don't have no friends. I don't try to make friends because they are trouble. The people that want to be my friends, they want something, but they want the wrong thing. So I try not to make friends. So I've been like, yeah. So I've been basically in my house and, trying to read, eat, what I watch a little TV, trying to get myself together. So I have to have one-on-one.
Okay. Do you smoke cigarettes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now you're going to have to do your part in throwing those cigarettes away. God's going to free you from the spirit that's behind that addiction. But you have to do your part in throwing that cigarette away and not going back to the store and purchasing another pack. That's on you. That's what you're going to have to do. But God's going to do what you can't do, which is get rid of that spirit that is causing that addiction. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have cigarettes in your purse or bag or whatever?
No, I have...
Carrying?
What I was doing was... I would buy a few cigarettes, like skeet the bootlegger, so you know. I would buy a few from them, and then I would leave my house and go out just about all day, and in the evening time when I get home, I probably would smoke then. It was more so I'm trying to, I'm trying to stop smoking, but I would never take none with me, like when I go out, you know, house, but I would be home,
yeah,
and I'd buy a few from, like, the bootlegger, and I would sit and smoke then. So
yeah,
I'm trying to help.
Yeah.
Yeah, God's going to get rid of the demon spirit that has actually caused that addiction. He's going to get rid of the demon spirit. But you're going to have to get rid of the cigarette. You're going to have to be one not to go and buy another cigarette. When you get home, the cigarettes that's there, you're going to have to break them up in the commode and flush them down the toilet and no longer go purchase a cigarette. That, now, you have to do that part. But God's going to do his part in getting rid of that spirit that is behind that addiction. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now the main demon that you are dealing with, Renee, is a spirit husband. That's what caused you to be unfaithful to God in the spirit in committing first spiritual fornication and then physical fornication. Is that spirit?
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to trust the Holy Spirit to bring to your remembrance of when you were married or espoused to this man in the spirit. Now, you know about man in this natural realm, but you didn't know there was a so-called man in the spirit realm that is calling itself to be your boyfriend or your husband. In other words, you're going to say your spirit lover. So you get human lovers in this natural realm, but there's a spirit lover in the spirit realm that really is the one who calls you to seek and look for a human lover in this physical realm. Okay? So somewhere, Renee, in your childhood, you were molested. There was a molestation. And molestation is you come into the knowledge of sex before your time as a child.
Yes, ma'am.
What thought has the Holy Spirit brought to you in regard to molestation?
My cousins, when we first moved here, I think I was six, and we had just moved to Florida, and they were, I would spend the night with my cousin, and that's the first time I ever knew anything about it. I didn't have an understanding of what was really going on.
That's when you were also assigned to a spirit man or a spirit lover. And your cousin also was molested. That's the reason why they became the molestor. Because they was molested. But again, Renee, God's gonna set you free. He's gonna set you free, but after he set you free, then you have your part to play. You have to remain in submission to God. Now, are you on any type of a medication?
I don't take that medication. I just go get it and sit it on my coffee table.
They're trying to describe to you some type of a psychological medication.
Yes, ma'am.
I felt that, and I sense it, and I feel that thing. That it's a spirit. It's a spirit there. So you actually don't take it. You don't take it.
No, ma'am.
Now, there is a mental spirit that is in you who wants to drive you into being mental. That spirit is there because the Holy Spirit let me pick that thing up. It's there. Matter of fact, it's listening. But God's going to free you from it. So, do not take that medication. As a matter of fact, flush it down the commode because after your deliverance, that spirit is going to try to entice you to take that medication. So just flush it down the commode because the day you start taking it, you will get worse off because your problem is not a physical problem. It's a spiritual problem, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
You understand?
But I haven't took the medication in, oh, my goodness.
I know you
since
have.
Since last year.
Right.
Yes,
but what I'm saying is after your deliverance, you're gonna feel the spirit is going to attack you to make you feel like you want to take it. And you're going to wonder, why all of a sudden I want to take this medication? And I haven't taken it in a year. So the best thing to do is when you get home is to flush it down the commode. Just flush those pills down the commode. Okay? Because your again, your problem is not a physical problem; it's a spiritual problem. And actually, you know, those that when you were molested at six, it opened the door for spirit husband. Spirit husband was the one who opened the door for those other spirits. Now, in times past, did you ever have a stillness of wanting to commit suicide?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, see, all those spirits come together. See, all those spirits, they group themselves together. But God's going to get you totally free, Renee. And you thank God because he loves you. He cares for you. You know, he have a plan, a purpose for you, and it's going to be fulfilled on this earth, and that you bring him glory. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Amen. So I'm going to pray for you. And what I want you to do, I don't know about your surroundings. Don't pay your surroundings no attention. Don't give your attention to your surroundings. You focus on what God's about to do in your life, and within yourself, be thanking God. Say, Jesus, thank you for your grace and mercy and setting me totally free so that I'm free now to serve you as I always desire and want to do. I'm free to serve you in spirit and truth. You think about those things, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Amen. So I'm going to pray now. So, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for your daughter, Renee. Father, I thank you, thank you, thank you, Father, that every plan and idea and purpose you have for Renee is going to take place and shall take place on this earth and bringing only glory to your son, Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you for rinsing and cleansing her thoroughly by your fire of your spirit, Father, watching her, making her whole in every area of her life, Father, so she can serve and worship you and bring in you glory. Father, I ask you to give her an understanding. Open up her mind, her spiritual mind, her physical mind. Father, thank you for healing her brain, Father. I just thank you, Father, for healing the organ of her brain, Father, where she can understand and comprehend who she is in your son, Jesus, and also who Jesus is in her. I just thank you for your angels who have dispatched themselves around her, keeping her safe from the evil and the wicked one, Father. And I thank you for keeping her, Father, this day. Father, we just praise you and exalt your holy name forever and ever. Father, I thank you that you said whatever we bind and loose on this earth, you will bind and loose in heaven. So I'm taking authority in Jesus' name. You spirit husband, in the name of Jesus, I command you to pack your load and go in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, you get out. You come out of God's house. Holy Ghost fire, burn. Burn, Holy Spirit, from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Burn, Holy Spirit. Set her body ablaze in Jesus' name. There is no distance in the spirit realm, and I command you to loose her and let her go. Holy Ghost, fire, burn, burn all manner of mental spirits in her mind that is lurking and hiding in her mind. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in her mind. Burn in her will. Burn in her emotion. Burn in her body. Holy Ghost, fire, set her body ablaze. Set her body ablaze in Jesus' mighty name. Set her body, come out of her mind. Holy Ghost, fire. Holy Ghost, fire. Burn, burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. There's no death in the spirit realm. You hear me? Come out. Holy Ghost, fire. Burn in her belly. Burn all manner of snakes and eggs and poison out of her belly. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in her mouth. Burn in her tongue. Burn down her throat. Burn in her ears, in her eyes, in her vagina, everywhere that is a hole, everywhere that is a more opening on her body. Burn, Holy Spirit, you spirit of nicotine. Come out of her. Holy Ghost, fire, burn, burn in Jesus' name. Burn, 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 burn in the name of Jesus. Take the sins of God, and I cut and detaches her from that unaccepted relationship, that color of a doctrine and witchcraft. The blood of Jesus set her free. The blood of Jesus set her free. The blood of Jesus set her free. Come out of her. Come out of her. Come out. Fire, fire, burn, burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn, lying spirit. Burn in Jesus' name. You let her go. You loose her and you let her go. Let go in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire continue to ransack. Ransack, ransack of mind, of will, emotion, body. Ransack, Holy Spirit. Leave no compartment untouched by your fire. Fire the Holy Ghost burn. Fire the Holy Ghost burn. Burn. Give a clean flushing, a clean sweeping by your fire. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. You only espouse the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Father, I ask you to send your angel, to dispatch your angel in the spirit realm. Gather every spirit that's not of you and send them where you desire to send them in the name of Jesus. Father, fill. Fill Renee with your spirit. Fill her mind. Fill her will. Fill her emotion. Fill her emotion. Fill her mind. Fill her will. Fill her body with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, you are free, Renee. You are free in your mind. You are free. You are free in your emotions. You are free. You are free in your body. You are free. And you are free in your will. In Jesus' mighty name, be free. Now, Father, I pray for Renee's dwelling place. Holy Ghost fire, go and set Renee's house ablaze. Set her dwelling place ablaze. Go in every room. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, burn in the east, south, west, north. Burn by your fire. All manner of darkness that is lurking, hiding in her house. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn under the bed, over the bed, around the bed. Burn, Holy Spirit. Go outside our home. Burn under the ground, around the house, over the house, and under the house in Jesus' mighty name. Burn by your fire in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for setting Renee in her house free this day. Father, we praise you without you. We glorify your holy name, Father, in Jesus' name. Renee?
Yes, ma'am.
In Jesus' name, your mind is free. Your will is free. Your emotions are free. And your body is free to serve the Lord thy God in spirit and in truth. Be free. In Jesus' mighty name, be free. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Glory to your holy name. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Amen, amen, amen. Renee?
Yes, ma'am.
You are now free. You're free now to serve the Lord with all your heart. You are free. Jesus has cleaned you from the inside out. You are free. Again, now, you have your part to play in this. When you go home, you have to be obedient and get those cigarettes, crumble them up in the commode, and then flush them. And no more walk and purchase cigarettes. That, now, this is something that you have to do. Okay, yeah. God cannot do this for you. You're going to have to. He already done what you could not do. You could not disconnect yourself in the spirit realm from these spirits. But Jesus did his part. So now you must do your part. It's done in Jesus' name. And when we hang up this phone and those young fellows try to get back in contact with you, you must disconnect from them because their intention is not godly. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
This is something that you have to do. See, Jesus is not going to do what we have to do. He only do what he could do and we cannot do. We have a part to play in this, okay? We have to stay submit to God. If you sin now, Renee, that is your choice. It's not the devil who's forcing you from the inside and that you sin. That would be Renee's choice to sin now because you are totally free on the inside. You are totally free. So you praise him and you thank him. You are forgiven and you are free. Indeed, you are totally free. Those devils are no longer in you, in Jesus' mighty name. So as I was praying, Sister Renee, what was you experiencing as I was praying? What was going on with you as I was praying?
I was basically thanking the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and it just told me to just thank the Lord. Just continue
Amen.
To thank him.
Amen. And it is done. It is done. It is finished in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So you thank your sister Anita for sending you to the woman of God so you can receive your complete deliverance and your complete healing. Because
yes,
it is done in Jesus' name. It is finished. You now is a new creation in Christ Jesus. Ashley Renee, in the spirit realm, you are a virgin. You are a virgin. In the spirit realm, you are a virgin. Praise his holy name. And make sure you attend a church. You know, you and Sister Anita get together. I don't know what church she goes to, but get with her.
Mm-hmm.
And attend a church where the pastor is ministering the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
Because you need to hear your father's voice so that you can live by every word that comes out of his mouth. So you seek to build your relationship in Christ Jesus. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
And let your conversation always be of Jesus Christ. When you find yourself talking about other things that don't build your faith in Christ Jesus, you stop. You say, no, No, I need to build my faith in Christ Jesus. And the only way you mm-hmm. build your faith in Christ Jesus is as you hear the word of God. And when you hear the word of God, you speak the word of God. Because you got to spiritually grow in the things of God. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
It is done. And when you go home, you may be laying down or you may drop off to sleep and just all of a sudden a demon spirit is visiting you in the dream. Well, you a spirit. Mm-hmm. You don't sleep. You just rebuke it and just remind it of the blood of Jesus. Just say the blood of Jesus. Just say Jesus.
Yes,
and that thing will get scared and it will run off. And the Lord says, no, that spirit is not in you. Is trying to get back into you, okay? Mm-hmm. Also, the Lord mm-hmm. said, don't forget to also take those pills and pour them and put it also in the commode and flush it down. Don't just let
yes,
it
ma'am.
Sit there, because when you let it sit there, you ain't got rid of it. And as long as you haven't
yes,
got
ma'am.
Rid of it, that's open ground for the enemy to tempt you. Again, you may not have had that temptation before to take
mm-hmm.
those pills, but now after you're delivered, you will have that temptation. So
yes,
the
ma'am.
Best thing to do is just to get rid of it and just speak
yes,
praises to God and share with others what great things God has done. Just tell others how merciful and graceful God has done for you, how he is so graceful and merciful towards you. Okay?
Yes,
you speak on his goodness from this day forth. And long you do these things, Renee, you'll be all right. Okay?
Thank
praise
you.
His holy name. All right, you continue to have a blessed day, okay?
All right, you too.
All right then. Bye-bye.
Okay.
Bye-bye, Nita.
Bye-bye, Nita.
Hi.
I said, bye-bye, have a blessed day.
You too.
Your friend is totally free indeed. And you
hallelujah.
Now, y'all make sure you keep your conversation a godly conversation. Uplift the name of Jesus, both of you two. Just brag on the Lord. Brag on his doing. That's what you two do together.
She's not all bragging on Lord. Yes, ma'am. We are doing just that. And,
Amen. Amen.
We have some work to do over here.
Yeah, you're in Florida. I get a lot of calls from Florida.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, those water spirits are really rambling in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
yes,
one more call.
As a matter of fact, on that subject of water spirits, we just this past weekend, we had the Black Heritage Festival.
Oh.
Yeah, and my son and I went, and you know how you go there and you go from one booth to booth to one booth to the other.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my goodness!
Mm-hmm.
The Holy Spirit was talking to me the whole time.
You saw the things too.
At every booth that I go to,
mm-hmm.
and there was one particular booth that the man he was making pendants. Jewelry and with clay.
Mm-hmm.
And my Lord.
looked like I was looking at a Nigerian warfare movie.
And exactly what it was.
I
oh,
mean,
that person know what they're doing.
Spirit.
That person know what they're doing. That man's a witch style. He knows that what he's doing.
Ooh,
a night
oh, my goodness.
Jeez.
There was another one that I went to jewelry. I wanted some copper, bracelet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, copper is good for you.
Mm-hmm.
And, oh, my goodness, all those. The Holy Spirit said, look at all the symbols. He was pointing them out. And there was one in particular that he really pointed out to me. And I asked the man, I said, what is this symbol? Oh, he said, what's that symbol?
They buy this stuff and get it home, get attacked by demons and wonder why.
Goodness gracious. Mm-hmm. Yes, Lord. The Holy Spirit was letting me know that, you know, a lot of people are getting initiated.
They're getting initiated. The kingdom of God is on the floor. And they
pressed
their eyes.
And then this man, he pulled down his shirt. He had that same tattoo at the base of his throat.
Oh, man. What?
I said, my Lord Jesus.
Yeah,
okay.
We thank you. We praise you. We
so, you know, yeah, I bought some shea butter and soap, some black soap.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, before I went there, I always anoint myself anyway, my hands, especially
mm-hmm.
my hands.
Mm-hmm.
And when I got home, I anointed it. I opened everything and poured my some anointing on it.
Now, what's the purpose of black soap that you bought?
African black soap?
Yeah, I mean black soap. That would throw me off. Why is it black?
Oh, because of the ashes. The ashes. They use the ashes from banana leaves.
Well,
they use that to make their potash.
Well, I think you better look that up, Anita. Something ain't right about that soap. I feel in my spirit there's something not right about that soap. You better look up and get the contents and the meaning.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
And you got to put it on your body too, because something's not right, and you could be initiated with that soap when you take that bath with it.
Okay,
I
haven't even used it yet either.
Yeah, you look that thing up. You look it up. Something just not right about it.
I did look it up on, you know, several times, but hey, it could be something I'm missing, so I'm going to look it up.
I'm going to ask my husband about the Roger Berry nozzle and things like that, but my spirit is not bearing witness with that black soap.
Okay.
The spirit in me is not bearing witness. Something about it is not right. And then when you take a bath with it, you may end up it being initiated.
No, they're not going to give me a batting the hatches down.
Yeah. And I'm glad you mentioned that. I'm going to ask Roger about it. And you said the man from Nigeria?
I'm not sure. I didn't ask him where he was from.
Okay.
I didn't ask a particular man.
I'm going to ask Roger. Roger, search on it. But it's just it's not bearing witness with the Holy Spirit in me that it's of God. Not that.
You know, as a matter of fact, this is a different black soap that I purchased this time. This was a black, like black jelly soap.
It's just that the point of it being a black soap, and you got to bathe your body with it. Hold it. Somebody put something up here. Let me read it. African black soap is revered for having skin nourishing benefits due to an abundance of antioxidants. The soap is made from the ashes of plantain.
Yes, ma'am. That's banana. That's plantain. That's banana.
That's
from the banana family.
The ashes of plantain skin, coconut pod, and palm leaf, and palm oil from leaves or kernels. Now, something just not right. Something is not right there. It's just not bearing witness with the Holy Spirit in me that it is of God. Something is just not right. And you got to bathe your body with it. It could be a subtle way of being, as you bathe your body, being initiated into the kingdom of joy. You said, just saw this on the website. Oh, that person just got off the website. No, spiritually speaking, there's something about it. It's something to it. You know what?
Dedicated it. It could be that.
Something about it's not right. I have a African friend. I'm a pastor who's in deliverance. I'm going to ask Rod to send him a message and ask him about it.
Okay.
Ask him about it and see. Something's just not right. And I got your number, right?
You have my number, don't you? 813.
Don't say that. Everybody be having your number, girl.
Oh, you said online?
Yeah.
I forgot we were online.
Yeah. Send me an email and I'll call you.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Girl,
all right.
I had your number here.
Oh, yeah, I have my phone blowing up with food.
I ain't kidding. Okay. All right, Anil, let me go and see what it's California. I'm waiting for a session. I think this will be my last one. You all stay blessed now. And remember, you two get together, you just brag on Jesus, okay?
Oh, yes, we are.
All right. All right, then. All right. Bye-bye.